aren't you going to say hello?
Oh, come on, bucko. Don't you want a balloon?
Hiya there, Georgie.
Hey guys, welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and today we're talking about clowns. Their main purpose is to bring joy and laughter, yet for some reason, according to a Vox survey from 2016, more people are afraid of clowns than they are of a terrorist attack, a family member dying, and even climate change. All of these things are much more real, scary possibilities with much more severe consequences than, well, someone with makeup. Now before we get into it, make sure you guys are subscribed, click that bell, and let me know in the comments down below if you're afraid of clowns or not. Personally, I'm not and never have been, but a large majority of people all over the world suffer from coulrophobia, which in definition is an abnormal fear of clowns. But have you ever wondered why? Well, today we're going to look into this fear, discuss where it stems from, and why it stays with people their entire lives. To get to the bottom of this, we need to go back to clowns' origins. Before clowns were known to entertain at birthday parties or scare you to death in the movie theater, they were used to entertain kings and queens in the medieval times, and even Egyptian pharaohs in 2500 BC. Although they were given the task to entertain the most prestigious figures in the country, nothing was off limits. They were the only ones allowed to poke fun at the king or queen and not be prosecuted for it.
Oh, can we have one dinner where we're not watching Jester?
I'll hit mute.
Oh no!
Because of this, it led people to believe clowns were different from everyone else, which may have led them to being seen as untrustworthy. Other theories believe clowns reminded the everyday person how crazy and unreasonable they could be at times. After all, these clowns were simply humans playing a character, but at the end of the day, they were still technically humans in costume. Many years later, in the 16th century, they were introduced as harlequins, where jesters were usually linked to death or dark truths, also seen as being conniving or mischievous. Although made to entertain, clowns seem to have been given a bad rap from the start. On top of this, they wear absurd clothing and had that makeup on their face, which, in a sense, hid the way they were really feeling. To expand on this, a clown with a painted-on smile frowning is quite a sight to see. Psychologically, it really confuses us because we're unsure how to feel about it. Again, uncertainty usually leads to fear. In the mid-1760s, when the circus came about, it started as a horse show for the most part. Soon after, other acts showed interest, which inspired the likes of acrobats, jugglers, and you guessed it, clowns. Although clowns were seen more as a comic relief and filler in between acts, it would be until one man really changed the game for clowns years later. Fast forward to the 19th century and Joey Grimaldi sets the bar for clowns. Being one of the most well-known clowns of his time and setting the standard for how clowns look in today's society, with their white face and heavy makeup, Grimaldi was a celebrity of sorts. However, this meant people knew about his life as a clown and as a real person. Although he would dress up to entertain, with the makeup and a big smile, Grimaldi's personal life was quite grim. His first wife passed away while giving birth to their child. His son was an alcoholic who died at just 30 years old. And given his circumstances, when Grimaldi would put on that makeup, he'd prance around bringing joy to those all over. This again led many to fear or at least have a notion that just because clowns are perceived as happy, who knows what's really going on inside the person portraying the clown. To make matters worse, Grimaldi's shtick was slapstick and his tumbles and leaps led to him having problems with his health down the road. So much so, he was quoted saying, "I am grim all day, but I make you laugh at night." After his passing in 1837, Charles Dickens would be responsible for editing Grimaldi's memoirs, which again led many to believe you can't trust the man behind the makeup. Although he's making audiences laugh and keeping them entertained with a painted-on smile, the idea that he's really hurting inside left a bad taste in everyone's mouth. They felt for the guy. To make matters worse, in 1836, a year before Grimaldi's death, another popular clown had his fair share of troubles. Jean-Gaspard de Breau was a major celebrity in the streets of Paris, known for being a mime of sorts. With his white face and red lips, people loved the man. However, in 1836, de Breau killed a boy by beating him with his walking stick after the boy insulted the French clown. Although he was acquitted of the murder, the two most popular clowns in Europe were known to be less than pleasant. One was dealing with a grim reality, while the other was a murderer. However, when the circus came to America, the state of clowns somewhat changed. The idea of sad, hobo-type clowns, most famously done by Emmett Kelly, brought humor to those all over. With their 5 o'clock shadow, raggedy clothing, and unhappy look, something about the contrast made people laugh. These clowns were usually the blunt of the joke, example being a pie in the face. When we get into the 20th century, clowns, for the most part, are seen as positive figures aimed toward entertaining kids. With the likes of Bozo the Clown, who was the host of the insanely popular Bozo the Clown Show, which aired internationally in the 60s.
"Today, my pal Professor Tweety Fooper is going to stop by, and wowee kazowie, do we have fun when he's around."
And then the introduction of McDonald's mascot, Ronald McDonald, it seemed like clowns were responsible to bring love and laughter to children all over. Although their history was still known to some, many didn't see them as threatening or fearful. But then came the dark side of clowns once again. With this idea that clowns were always hiding something, there was a deep-rooted suspicion in all of us. Usually it was just flowers or a long string of cloth in many different colors. However, one man really changed America's perception of clowns, and soon made headlines all over. Pogo the Clown, real name John Wayne Gacy, would perform as a clown for children in Chicago, at community events, and even at birthday parties. To the public, he was a friendly, hard-working, regular guy who had a passion for entertaining people when he had the time. In reality, he was a sadistic man who sexually assaulted and killed dozens of young men between 1972 and 1978. Before his arrest in 78, Gacy told the cops, "You know, clowns can get away with murder." He was then nicknamed Killer Clown. If this wasn't enough, in 1982, the film Poltergeist showed an evil clown dragging a boy under his bed. Stephen King then wrote a horrifying thriller titled It, which followed an evil entity, usually taking the form of Pennywise the Dancing Clown, terrorizing little children. In 1988, Killer Clowns from Outer Space saw alien clowns with sharp teeth, although not the most believable, trying to kill to fill their thirst for human blood. Then there was Clown House a year later, which saw three escaped mental patients disguised as clowns killing people. Great. What really set the standard was the mini TV series which turned Stephen King's horror novel into a reality. Following that smash hit, we saw endless TV shows, movies, and even novels revolving around scary killer clowns. From Pennywise to the clown type puppet in the Saw franchise, and even the Joker, who's a maniac in a clown costume of sorts, the scary clown idea has thrived in film and TV. And if the fear of clowns was slowly dying down, it came back to life during the 2016 killer clown craze, when everyone from teens to adults were literally scared of criminals just dressing up as clowns to commit crimes. From the guy in Sweden who got cut by a knife wielding clown, to the Taco Bell that was robbed by two men wearing clown masks, professional clowns actually had a hard time getting work due to this not so newfound fear. It seems the history of us being scared of clowns goes back to the beginning of time, and they will always be seen as terrifying for some. Personally, I don't have any issues with clowns, nor do I think I ever will. I mean, obviously a clown with a knife is unsettling, but regular clowns at a circus or a parade, for example, doesn't scare me at all. That being said, some have such severe cases of coulrophobia, they literally have panic attacks at the sight of clowns, with some sweating, vomiting, and although coulrophobia isn't an official term, at least according to the dictionary, maybe it should be. As always, I love to hear from you guys, so be sure to drop us some comments below with your thoughts on clowns. Do they scare you? Why or why not? For now, we got some comments from the video, "What if piranhas doubled in size?" Sneaky said, "Well, they would get bigger." Thanks, Tips. Appreciate your input. Jason Webb said, "Life's biggest questions rock. My kids will run in the house just to see if y'all have posted anything yet that day. Anyway, peace out, peeps." Appreciate it, Jason. Tell your kids we say hi from everyone at LBQ. We really appreciate your support, and hopefully they don't get scared of clowns after watching this one. Ultimate Otaku said, "When I get drunk and I'm about to puke, it normally takes 3 seconds. Thank you for letting us know that. Maybe just to work harder on trying not to do that and focus on breathing deep breaths. I don't know, when I'm drunk, I usually just take deep breaths, get some fresh air, and throw up the next morning. And on that note, guys, we're gonna wrap this one up. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. If you guys enjoyed the video, of course, give us a thumbs up. Let us know in the comments down below if you're afraid of clowns and where that fear comes from. If you're not afraid of clowns, I wanna know which clown in pop culture scares you the most. So the Jigsaw Clown or It the Clown, the Joker. Let me know in the comments down below if there's a clown that scares you by any means. Of course, make sure you guys are subscribed and click that bell notification so you guys can be notified when we post more videos. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, here for you on Life's Biggest Questions, and we'll see you guys in the next one. We'll be right back.